After a late Monday Night Football victory over the Browns, we are here for you today, Steeler Nation, and I think a lot of us. You know, maybe if you didn't stay up for the whole game and you woke up this morning for work or school, you looked at your phone, you saw some highlights on the news, and you said, wow, look at that. Steelers get the win 26-22 over the Browns. That's 21 straight Monday Night Football wins, but we were all waking up like this guy who, Bob, I saw you posted this yesterday. Now, this was on KDK before the game, right?
Yeah, it's tailgating before the game.
All right, so KDK's out there tailgating before the game. But this guy, this four-second clip I'm going to play of this guy tailgating, this is how we're all waking up this morning. Whether you watched the whole game last night, you went to bed like this guy, or if you didn't stay up for the whole game, you woke up, you saw the highlights, you saw the score on your phone, you're waking up, we are waking up, Pittsburgh, we're waking up with a victory, and then there's this guy.
Let's go Steelers!
It sounds like everybody's uncle.
It does.
The way, when you hear this guy do his Let's Go Steelers, right?
Let's go Steelers!
The guy you're picturing in your head.
It's him.
It's him.
It's
that's,
him.
That's the guy. Whatever you're picturing right now, like that weird, that's the guy.
Let's go Steelers!
Dude. All right. I want everybody to, this is the scenario right here. Just imagine. Now, again, this was before the game. This was tailgating that the guy dropped up.
Let's go Steelers!
I love the laugh, too.
I know.
It's
I
a
know.
Laugh right before it. Like, he's like, you know, they probably, whoever's got the camera, the microphone, is probably just like, wait, are you excited for the Steeler game night? And he's like, and then
Let's go Steelers!
It's like, it's like he just cocked it back. It was,
he does. He takes that breath and loads up.
Scott Steelers!
Let's go Steelers!
Yeah. All right, hold on. You can hear maybe the woman who has the camera, the microphone from KDK in the background just go, wow!
Let's go Steelers!
All right, I love how we're breaking down this clip, this four-second clip of this guy yelling, Let's go Steelers, more than we're even going to probably break down the game today. Because listen, a lot of us are just waking up and looking at our phones. He's going, oh man, I fell asleep in the fourth quarter. Did Steelers win? And then you see they won. And then
let's go Steelers!
All right, lots to do on the show today. We'll hear from the Steelers' new sack leader, TJ Watt. We'll hear from Kenny Pickett. We'll hear from Coach Tomlin. We'll talk about the Fire Matt Canada chants that were ringing throughout the stadium. And two rounds of Steelers Bronze Facebook comments coming up around 7:10 and 9:10 this morning. It's Mikey and Bob. Let's have a day here, Pittsburgh.
Let's go Steelers!
I'm about to watch this. I've avoided the Chubb until now. Bob is going to show me the gruesome Nick Chubb injury in slow motion for the first time. Yeah, I haven't seen this. Oh, my God! Okay, that wins.
I told you.
It's
not going in the right direction.
The leg, the bottom half of the leg at the knee.
Yeah, stop.
It's a 90-degree angle.
It stopped.
His leg is in the ground.
It is bad.
It goes up to the knee and then just goes over. It makes an L.
Yeah, his yeah. All-timer. All-time bendy leg.
Oh, man. All right. Whew. I'm going to pass that. Oh, I don't like injuries like that,
should've
man.
Should have kept your Chubb blinders on.
I shouldn't have looked at the Chubb, man, because now I'm all sweaty. I looked at the Chubb for too long. I'm all sweaty now. After a Steeler win, doesn't matter how they got it, we're all happy, right? It's better to win than it is to lose.
It is.
Oh, no. There was Fire Matt Canada chants throughout the stadium at points last night. So let's dive into it. It is time to read some Steeler Facebook comments. Here
Beware.
We go.
We are going to a very deep, dark place on the internet. Everyone is a GM.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone is a coach.
Yep.
Everyone is going to get traded.
Everything sucks.
It's time for Steelers Facebook comments.
These are Steelers Facebook comments after their Monday Night Football win 26-22 against the Browns, taking them to 1-1 on the early season. We will start here with Permane Brothers.
Wow.
Now, this is like legit from the Permane Brothers account. Note, we will not be opening a Permane Brothers restaurant in Canada Canada stinks. Oh, man, Permane brothers.
Boom.
And then FYI, not talking about the country. Damn, dude.
Got him.
Yo, Matt Canada's got to go. It's not the play calling, but once Permane brothers, a Pittsburgh staple, comes for you, you got to be like, all right, I gotta get out of here then.
Steelers Facebook comments after their win against the Browns. Andrew R., I agree with everyone in that stadium when they were chanting, Fire Canada! All right, so that's where we're starting off here. Thomas M., Tomlin needs to be fired.
Oh, wow.
Naj needs to be traded.
Wow.
Gunner needs to be cut.
Oh.
Best wishes for Chubb.
A classy end of that comment, right? Look at that.
Look at that.
Fire that coach. Trade the first round running back. Cut. What the hell's Gunner doing out there? He's a training camp. Get him out of here. Best wishes, Nick Chubb.
Classy, right?
Very
there.
Very classy.
Steeler fans being classy.
Donald P., bring back Todd Haley.
Careful.
What are we doing here?
Careful. Yeah, when he was offensive coordinator, everybody hated him and wanted him gone, too.
Did he get knocked out at Tequila?
Oh, man.
Tequila
Cowboy? How late were you at Tequila Cowboy last night?
Didn't he get kicked out? Like, you almost went tacos there?
It wasn't coming together, man.
Late night for Bob last night. Were you drinking at Tequila? Did you shut down Tequila Cowboy last night? Didn't Todd Haley get kicked out, Todd?
I made it.
Steelers Facebook comments after their 26-22 win against the Browns. Sharon L., go Steelers. I was in bed in my Steelers PJ. When TJ Watt scored, I woke the whole damn hoss up.
Hell yeah, Sharon.
Hell yeah, Sharon.
Adam S., been a ticket holder for the past 15 years. And that game was hairier than your aunt in the 70s. Woo! Okay, that's a what? Usually when you start with the credentials of, I've been a Steeler fan for 15 years.
Somebody's getting fired.
Yeah, then you say you have the ability to fire people. That's usually when Tomlin or Canada gets fired, not,
this game was hairier than your aunt in the 70s.
All right.
Whoa.
Michael G., call him TJ Big Sack Watt. Do we need to call TJ Watt Big Sack? I don't think we need to call him Big Sack.
Never heard that nickname before.
His mom named him TJ. We're going to call him TJ.
Hey, here comes Big Sack.
James S. What's up with Kenny? Is there a Big Ben quarterback curse or something? Yeah, there is. Yeah.
The curse of Ben?
Ben in his basement has a Kenny Pickett voodoo doll. It's an actual Ken doll from the Barbie movie. He's just got it.
Pinching his nipples?
No, it's not. He's throwing interceptions is what he's doing with the Ken doll. He's not pinching. All right, maybe he's pinching the nipples. Why did you go straight for his pinching the nipples? I was going to go, yeah, he's throwing fake Ken doll interceptions. He's touching that Ken doll's nipples.
First thing that popped in my head.
Steelers Facebook comments here after the win against the Browns. Brian D., great job defense, and great job Sticks for writing Renegade. You know what?
Thank you, Sticks.
Thank you, Sticks. Thank you, Sticks. Alex M., Mike Tomlin is a talentless hack who rode the coattails of Ben Roethlisberger, Hines Ward, and all the other star players that made him look like a genius. Come back, Bill Cowher, and get rid of Matt Canada. And we'll end here. One more comment for this round. You all know where it's got to end with this comment. He's got to go. We need to send him up to the fictional crossroads.
Okay.
Never coming back. Brandon M., send Matt Canada to the crossroads. Mikey and Bob. That's right. We're being instructed to send him to the crossroads in the Steelers Facebook comments. There he goes.
Oh, damn.
Send him there, Mikey and Bob.
He's gone.
The Fire Canada chance happened. Send him to the crossroads. Bring Todd Haley back from Tequila Cowboy. And I'm going to miss Canada. And I'm going to miss Canada. Stop everything right now. Bob, you already know.
Yeah, I know.
That we need to stop everything and make fun of what happened to you on the show here. I don't know if you had a late night last night like we all did and just stayed up too late and your brain's not working. But you trying to say tequila cowboy this morning?
It didn't happen.
It might be the highlight of the show. It might. But we got a lot of Steeler stuff going on.
It didn't come out right.
You trying to simply pronounce tequila cowboy, very popular bar right across, you know, from Stage AE in Acrisure. Here is Bob just trying to say tequila cowboy and failing miserably.
Did he get knocked out at tequila cowboy?
Oh, man.
Tequila Cowboy?
How late were you at Tequila Cowboy last night? Didn't he get kicked out? Man, you fell apart, dude.
You can hear my brain, like, just not working.
It just, you are rattled.
Didn't he get knocked out at Tequila Cowboy?
Somebody just hit the off switch in the middle of that.
Didn't he get knocked out at Tequila Cowboy?
Dude, you almost had Tequila Cowboy the first time.
Close.
But then, like, you had tequila, and then when you went, you could not complete the cowboy. You could not complete the cowboy and Tequila Cowboy there.
Didn't he get knocked out at Tequila Cowboy?
Like, you had the first tequila, man. You had it.
I did.
You had the first tequila and Tequila Cowboy, but then cowboy was not happening. That was too much for your late night Monday night football brain to process. You could not do Tequila Cowboy.
Didn't he get knocked out at Tequila?
Dude, after you failed at the cowboy, I don't even know what you're trying to say next.
Didn't get knocked out at Tequila
Cowboy. Like you're throwing L's and then just it was a mess, man.
Didn't get knocked out at Tequila
All right. Now let's add that to our. Listen, I know it's going to be all about Steelers today, and we'll get to the Fire Matt Canada chance coming up next.
Yep.
But we need to properly do this. Add Bob's Tequila Cowboy screw up to one of our compilations of some of the best screw ups we've had in recent memory on the show.
Morning, commute.
Commute?
Commute.
Commute. Morning, commute. What? Throw an R in there? What happened to commute there?
Well, simply. That's the word I was looking for. What happened there?
Don't think that means that Kenny Pickup is necessarily the backup
Kenny
now.
Kenny Pickup?
Did I say Kenny Pickup?
We did get a Kenny Pickup.
Moose sneaking there. Number. Wow, what was that I just said there? If they're going to be knee-deep in cow pop. Okay, hold on. Let me.
What was that?
No, hold on. They are going to be knee-deep in the hold on.
Clown? What are we going with?
Hold on. This.
What?
It has nothing to do with clowns. Hold on. They're going to be knee-deep in the cow plop all season with this offensive line. It was cow plop. I'm about to talk.
Uh-oh. What are we doing?
My wife, Jamie, was not riding on me. My wife, Jamie. All right, hold on. My wife, Jamie, was not riding with me on this purchase, was what I was trying to say.
Wasn't on purpose, or at least I don't know it was.
Yeah.
Maybe subliminally.
Oh, man.
Subliminally.
Is that a tough one for you?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
Subliminally. Nope.
And we have your tants. We have your chants.
Didn't he get knocked out at Tequila?
Oh, man.
Tequila Cowboy?
How late were you at Tequila Cowboy last night?
Didn't he get kicked out?
Dude, it's an all-timer now. It's an all-time. I did not expect an all-time screw-up on the show, but Bob trying to say Tequila Cowboy.
Didn't he get knocked out at Tequila Cowboy?
Has now been added to the list of all-time show screw-ups. A lot of us waking up a little tired this morning because stayed up late for Monday Night Football. Steelers beat the Browns 26-22. We're always waking up like this guy in the Acrisure parking lot tailgating before the game on KDK.
Let's go Steelers!
That's what happens when you wake up if you fell asleep during the game or you didn't know they won and you woke up, you look at your phone and you're like, oh wow, 26-22.
Let's go Steelers!
Yeah. All right, but hold on. We need to discuss what happened later in the game when the crowd started chanting so loudly, Fire Canada. Obviously, people have problems with Steelers' current offensive coordinator, Matt Canada. Here is some of the Fire Canada chants last night. That's
That's so loud.
I mean, that's booming through there.
And listen, I get that some people are going to be like, why are we even doing that? We should support the guys, and you can't be chanting that. No, that is loud. Don't mess with Pittsburgh. The last time this happened, why don't you go ask Ron Hextall how that story ended, huh? Like,
seriously,
we're not talking about Steeler fans are different than Penguins fans. No, some of those fans just cross the streams, right? Like, we're all Pittsburghers, and the last time in Pittsburgh there was a fire someone chant, Ron Hextall lost his job right after
it happened. Yeah, you're right.
Kenny Pickett was asked after the game about the Fire Canada chants. Here is the question and Kenny's answer. This is masterful what Kenny Pickett does here. Here's the question and the answer to Kenny about the Fire Canada chants.
What were you guys thinking, or could you hear the chanting for firing Matt Canada in the second half there?
No. You know, we were locked in on winning the game. I was going over 2-minute, 4-minute scenarios with the guys, you know, yeah, find a way to win, whatever we needed to do there at the end. But, you know, hats off to our defense, played unbelievable. You know, we got the best player in the world, in my opinion, in 90, and 56 man is close behind. You know,
he's
unbelievable.
Yeah.
So those guys did a hell of a job, and, you know, happy that they're on our side.
Oh, Kenny Pickett's not a rookie anymore. Completely, ladies and gentlemen.
Took that question, turned it upside down.
The question was, did you hear the Fire Matt Canada chants? And the question ends with Kenny Pickett talking about how great TJ Watt and Alex Highsmith are. Kenny is a pro at
pro
this.
Pro move.
All right, Coach Tomlin was also asked about Matt Canada. Maybe not specifically about the Fire Canada chants that were, again, obviously ringing through the stadium. Coach Tomlin was just asked about Matt Canada in the slow starts for the offense. Here is the question and answer, sort of answer, from Coach Tomlin after the win last night about Matt Canada's offensive play calling.
In terms of the slow start of Kenny Pickett, it seems like it's starting to be recurrent. They talk about Matt Canada, but I don't think it's all on Coach Canada. I think that the slow start of Kenny has to take its own responsibility.
Question. What's the question?
All right, so I love when that happens. Just so that person's actually almost defending Matt Canada and say some of the blame should go on Kenny Pickett.
Right, right.
And then Coach Tomlin's just like, okay.
Question?
It's late. I want to go home and I want to go to bed, but.
Question. What's the question?
What's the question? All right, so here's.
Question is, are you going to do anything to spur them or either one of them to kind of maybe up the ante a little bit?
Certainly.
Okay. All right. What's the question?
Certainly.
You're gonna
move it on.
Like, okay, yeah. I'm like,
there's no way they didn't all hear that chant, by the way. That thing was booming.
Yeah, it was a loud chant. And listen, nobody can say, well, that's just fans and fans don't get it. Go ask Ron Hextall about it. Us here in Pittsburgh, we know when it's time for somebody to go, and it might just be time for Matt Canada to go. Let's get to what Kenny Pickett had to say after the game. It wasn't a great game for Kenny. He was 15-30 and threw a touchdown, that 71-yarder to George Pickens, also had an interception. Here was Kenny Pickett talking about, you know, obviously the defense stepping up huge and scoring 2 touchdowns themselves.
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, you got a defense like that. They make plays and put points up on the board and get those turnovers. It's unreal as an offense to have that. You know, we want to return that favor, though. You know, I feel like we let those guys out there way too long. There's things that we got to do a lot better offensively to also help those guys out.
Yeah, when the defense outscores the offense, like, you're happy they got the win.
Hell yeah.
Offense needs to do a better job. Kenny knows it, too.
Go, go, Kenny Pickett. Come on, Kenny. Go, go, Kenny Pickett.
All right, Kenny was also asked, what can they do better offensively?
Staying on the field, third downs, putting points up. I mean, very, very ABC vanilla stuff.
Yeah.
Playing better offensively, period.
Okay, all right. Good answer there. And then Kenny was asked, you know, well, he was basically just telling everybody, hey, by the way, winning in the NFL, not the easiest thing.
Winning's hard in this league. It's really hard. Feel like as you watch around the league, it always comes down to one possession, it feels like, at the end of the game.
Hell yeah.
So however we had to get it done, I'm happy that we got it done as a team. Look forward to getting back out there in another primetime game.
Oh yeah, back out there.
Primetime Kenny!
Sunday in Vegas!
Oh yeah!
Go, 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 Kenny Pickett! Come on, primetime Kenny! Go, go, Kenny Pickett!
Kenny was asked, you know, did he want to take more downfield shots? You got George Pickens. Obviously, they connected for a 71-yard touchdown pass. But Kenny was asked, you know, did you want to do that more? You want to go downfield a little bit more? Basically, here's your chance to rip on Matt Canada.
No, I mean, listen, we couldn't get behind him, really. They were doing a good job of doubling George. Hit some good inbreakers. You know, there's definitely positive to build off of. Like I've been saying, it's hard to win in this league. So take the positives, learn from the negatives, and move forward.
All right.
Go, go, Kenny Pickett!
No, we were off on that one.
A little bit.
We got one more chance.
Go, go, Kenny Pickett!
All right, that last one felt good. We got the last one. What is it? We got like 2 hours of sleep last night. What do you want from us? We tried to hit the go, go, Kenny Pickett as good as we can. By the way, did you see the girl who made a go, go, Kenny Pickett sign for yesterday,
yeah,
too?
Like, yep.
I don't know, man. Like, listen, I know it's sort of becoming a thing, but until I see a go, go, Kenny Pickett Power Rangers shirt in the strip district, it's not a thing.
Not yet.
You're not a thing until you're a thing in the strip district in Pittsburgh. Yeah. Then we read the Steelers Facebook comment section.
Beware.
Oh, boy, here we go.
We are going to a very deep, dark place on the internet.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Everyone is a GM.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Everyone is a coach.
Yep.
Everyone is going to get traded.
Everything sucks.
It's time for Steelers Facebook comments.
Let's see how many times offensive coordinator Matt Canada and others will be sent to the crossroads even after a Steelers victory. Greg L. barely squeaked out a win against a crap Browns team. Flush the damn toilet. This season is over. Oh, damn! If it's brown, flush it down. But if it's black and gold, flush it down too.
We're flushing the toilet already.
Week 2, the season has been flushed.
It's over.
And a minimum Steeler football. And a minimum Steeler football. Chris M, this team has no nuts. Tomlin and Canada need to go retire to a rocking chair in a porch. Bring back Bill Cowher.
Oh man,
that's right. The year is 2023.
Oh man,
and we're still yelling for Bill Carr to come back. Joe D, bring back Ben Roethlisberger. Let him call the damn plays.
Oh,
enough of this crap with Matt Canada.
Coach Ben.
We need Ben.
Okay.
Or let Mason Rudolph play because Kenny Pickett ain't it. Okay.
Player coach, Ben Roethlisberger. Hell yeah.
We need Ben or Mason because Kenny isn't it. Okay. Have you seen Mason? We've seen him play, right?
We've seen this.
Mason Rudolph is not the great unknown. We know what he brings to the table. Steelers Facebook comments after their win Monday Night Football against the Browns. Dana C here. Replace Matt Canada.
Oh, wow.
With Big Ben.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Man, there goes Canada again, though.
He's gone.
Oh, damn! Matt Canada. Permanent residence.
Coach Ben.
In the crossroads.
Get in there.
I mean, people want Ben to come back and
coach
and play.
Why
What's
not?
Happening? And I'm going to miss Canada. And I'm going to miss Canada. All right, let's go to Matthew F. here. Fire Matt Canada. The middle school football team I coach scores more points.
Maybe not that guy, coach.
Kimberly A., this game was embarrassing. I had to change the channel. Get rid of Tomlin and Canada along with Kenny Pickett. Oh, damn! Everybody then?
Just turn the TV off.
TV turned off.
Kenny's gone, too.
Tomlin's gone.
Yeah.
Canada's gone.
Yeah.
Everybody's gone.
Oh, man.
Let him miss everyone.
Let him miss everyone.
Rick F. here in the Steelers Facebook comments.
Rick.
Dan Rooney and the Chief are rolling in their graves watching this offense. No, they're not, Rick.
No, they're not.
Debbie H. Franco Harris is smiling down and helping this team. That win felt magical. All right, wait, hold on 1 second here. Franco Harris is, wait, hold on. So you have Dan and the Chief rolling in their graves? But Franco is smiling Don on the offense.
Just, hell yeah.
If everybody needs to know where, you know, dead people connected to the organization are and how they're reacting.
Franco smiling Don. Magical.
But Dan and the Chief are rolling in their graves. Chad L. Knock, knock.
Oh, boy. Who's there?
Fire Matt Canada. Oh, damn. Oh, got ya.
Knock, knock.
Knock, knock.
Who's there? Fire Matt Canada. Send him to the crossroads. He's never coming back.
And I'm going to miss Canada. And I'm going to miss Canada.
You can send us messages if you're streaming 96.1 KISS or our Mikey and Bob podcast on our free iHeartRadio app. Let's get to this.
Hey, Mikey and Bob. It's your boy, Snuffabus, out in San Diego. Can we get a... Here we go.
Here we go.
Hell of a game. Thank God we won. And hopefully there's not too many Facebook comments. Who are we kidding? Heck yeah, bring on the Facebook comments.
Yeah.
Steelers.
All right, yeah. Let's get to Coach Tomlin's comments after the big Steelers Monday night win. It was ugly, but they still got the win, and Coach Tomlin's just happy to be 1-0 in the AFC North.
Man, 1-0 in the AFC North, man. We don't take that for granted. We're appreciative. There's no blink approach. Obviously, it wasn't easy tonight, but we didn't expect it to be. It's a kind of a signature of AFC North ball, and particularly these two teams. They had momentum. They were coming off of a big win, and so we didn't get the type of fluidity we wanted early, but I like the fight. Obviously, the big play, the pick six was a nice catalyst, but after that, it took us a while to gain rhythm. We gave up another big run, and so we got some things, obviously, to work on. It's cool to work on it. With the win.
Yeah, obviously in the game last night, we saw one of the more gruesome football injuries you'll ever see with Browns running back. He might be the best running back in football. He's definitely top five, if not top three. Nick Chubb. Minka hit him low in the leg, and his
body just kept going. His leg did not.
Yeah, his leg stuck in the ground, and his body kept going. It was disgusting. I actually avoided the video, like the slow motion replay, until this morning when Bob showed me live on the air, and I think I almost passed out. Here was Coach Tomlin just on Nick Chubb and then the Steelers injury updates.
Can't say enough about Nick Chubb, man, sending our best to him. Got a lot of respect for that guy. We had some injuries of our own in-game. Gunner is being evaluated for a concussion. Mika is being evaluated at the hospital with a chest injury. We got to assess all of those things, man, and put together a plan here in a short week to go to Vegas. And so... we're thankful for the win, but we'll keep pushing.
Yeah, Gunner, I think a lot of Steeler fans will be like, oh, he's got a concussion. Hopefully he gets better, but if he doesn't come back, we're good.
He can rest, yeah.
I'm super worried about Minka Fitzpatrick. That injury was weird. Like, I know he was part of the Nick Chubb play, but then, you know, he got hit later in the game. They say it's a chest thing, and he
had to go to the hospital for it.
Yeah, I'm really worried about what's going on with Minka Fitzpatrick. Coach Tomlin was also obviously asked sort of about Matt Canada, because obviously that's the topic today. It's yes, the Steelers won, but my God, this team, if this team had a competent offense that could put up, I don't know, 21, 24 points a game, something like that, like, with this defense,
it could get nasty.
We'd be rolling. Here is Coach Tomlin about sort of Matt Canada.
In terms of the slow start of Kenny Pickett, it seems like it's starting to be recurrent. They talk about Matt Canada, but I don't think it's all on Coach Canada. I think that the slow start of Kenny has to take its own responsibility.
Question. What's the question?
All right, so it's great. I love when local media will ask a question and then just get completely called out. But like, what's the question there?
What are we doing here?
So that guy's basically saying, like, this is not Matt Canada's fault. It's just as much Kenny Pickett's fault.
The question is, are you going to do anything to spur them or either one of them to kind of maybe up the ante a little bit?
Certainly.
I mean, no, he's not going to do anything. He's actually going to try to discourage the offense and say, all right, defense won us this game. Let's see if you can score no points next game.
Let's see what else we can do here.
I mean, some of the questions are just... I know if I played that question back to that guy, he'd be like, I blew it, man. I blew it.
I panicked.
It was after the game. It was late. I need, you know, like, but just some of these questions. And then Coach Tomlin, he said, you know, it's ugly, but he's not going to apologize for winning.
We're not going to apologize for winning.
That's it. You got to feel good today. Why? Because the Steelers won.
We're not going to apologize for winning.
And we'd all be in a worse mood if the Steelers would have lost. So Steelers with a big win. They now have another nationally televised big game, prime time. It'll be Steelers out in Vegas taking on the Raiders. Sunday night football coming up on NBC.
Morning, Mikey and Bob. I don't know if you guys talked about this yet, but Chubb got hurt pretty bad last night.
Yeah.
And our fans are just so awesome that they chanted Chubb as he was getting carted off the field.
Yeah.
Pittsburgh, we get crazy and we take our teams very seriously, but we're respectful, and I just think that's awesome.
Yeah.
Hope you guys have a great day.
All right, let me explain what happened here last night. The Browns' great running back, Nick Chubb, he destroyed his leg in one of the most gruesome football injuries you will see. I didn't even see it. I saw the play happen, but then they wouldn't show the replay.
Yeah.
And for good reason, because it's a gruesome injury. His leg sticks in the ground, and his whole body keeps moving, but his leg stays there, and it bends at like a 90-degree angle at the knee. It's
nasty.
Horrific.
Nasty.
Right? But I get that you want to be like, you know what? Steeler fans were chanting Chubb, and we're a classy bunch.
Good for us.
I don't know. Like, there's good fans and there's bad fans.
I don't know about all that.
Let me tell you what happened last night. It turned in to a, hey, man, this guy just, he might have ended his career, definitely his season. He's already had some injury issues. Hey, this guy, you know, these are warriors out here putting their bodies and their well-being on the lines for our stupid entertainment and fantasy teams.
I think they played that replay in the stadium.
They did. Absolutely.
Everybody saw the replay.
That's what it was.
And gave him the courtesy clap of like.
Yeah. Okay. Like, yeah, this guy's not going to be playing for
everybody
a long time.
Everybody knew he wasn't coming back. It
right.
wasn't just like,
yeah.
oh, this is nice.
Yeah.
He's up. No, they know his ass is gone.
It's like, we don't need to worry about Nick Chubb for the next game against the Browns because this guy's not playing football for a long time, if ever again, because he's had some injury issues already, and it just sucks. But I go back to what she said, that Pittsburgh is what a great, classy. Here's what happened. It started with a couple uncles when Nick Chubb was down on the ground. And then all of a sudden, there's a couple uncles who are absolutely tanked. Like, they have been out in, you know, the gold lot.
Parking lot it up.
Early. Just getting it. They're barely coherent. A couple of uncles up there. Who got hurt? Is that Minka? Is Minka down? Oh, no, Minka looks like he's okay. Who'd he hit there? Is that Chubb down there? Oh, man, looks like Chubb. Oh, man, they're bringing out the cart.
Chubb down.
Oh, this is serious. Oh, Chubb's down. Oh, man, that sucks, man. I feel bad for that guy. He got hurt before. Hey, should we start chanting Chubb? Should we get a Chubb chant?
A Chubb chant?
A Chubb chant? Listen, I know she wants to say, hey, we're all classy, and we were clapping. It was just two uncles who were just like, we might be able to get like half a stadium chanting Chubb right now. This, like, for
half
the,
a Chubb? For,
was it the whole stadium?
Uh-uh. It was only half,
it was only half of Acrisure chanting for Nick Chubb as he gets carted off the field with a dangly leg that is going to need some major surgery. It wasn't a full Chubb. It was a half a Chubb because a couple of uncles are just like, hey, this is our golden opportunity. We are never going to get the chance again to get a Chubb chant going and half the stadium join in. Chubb! 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 Oh, it looks like half the stadium's doing it. We only got half a Chubb here in Pittsburgh. All right.
Uncle Frank's half Chubb?
Get well soon, Nick Chubb?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Get well soon, Nick Chubb. TJ Watt scores his first NFL touchdown. Man, Alex Highsmith had a game. That pick six, and then he had the strip sack of Deshaun Watson. Towards the end of the game, TJ Watt picks it up, scoops, and scores for the second defensive touchdown of the game. It was a big night for TJ Watt. He's unstoppable, really. He is. And now, and this always happens when you have somebody on the other side of a generational talent like TJ Watt, Alex Highsmith is just eating. He's already got a big contract because he's great and TJ Watt is on the other side. You double team TJ, you got to deal with Alex Highsmith, who is becoming a problem now, right?
Yep.
So TJ Watt also set the Steelers' all-time sack record passing James Harrison. TJ was asked after the game about getting the record.
I'd be lying if I said it wasn't special. Just like anything, it hasn't set in. I don't know if it will until I have time to really sit down and process what just happened tonight. But there's so many people along the way that have helped me get to where I am. I can't stand the individual awards of football because there's just, I mean, Debo himself helped me so much my rookie year. He didn't have to. No one asked him to, but he wanted to help me, and I appreciate him for that. So many of my teammates, coaches, mentors, my brothers, my wife's support, my parents. I mean, there's just so many people that go into it that it's not myself out there making the plays. I mean, there's just, I can't take all the credit.
Oh, just so humble, such a just great athlete and great role model. It's great, sack record and everything, but he thanked everyone except old El Paso there. Like, he was just running down the list about, yeah, we get it, TJ, team game and all that too, but also, like, you got Alex Highsmith a bunch of money because you're really good and he's good too, and this is just...
I'm Taco Boy.
He is Taco Boy, man. In the old El Paso... TJ Watt is in a lot of commercials now, and yes, he is in the old El Paso commercial where he's doing a play on Adam Sandler's The Water Boy, saying that he's Taco Boy. It's all just great fun, right? And here was TJ Watt on just, you know, how the Steelers were able to pull off the win.
Splash. I mean, I think that's what we talk about is creating splash as a defense. I mean, Alex Highsmith played his absolute tail off tonight. Yeah. Guys inside got incredible pressure. Larry O had a great game. I just think we really fed off the crowd, and I still think we can do a better job of executing in those moments when the crowd is going absolute bananas like they were tonight.
Yeah.
It wasn't pretty, but a win is a win.
All right. Now let's go to the beginning of this TJ Watt answer, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where he said splash, right? Like, because splash plays did get the win for the Steelers.
That's what got it done, yeah.
TJ Watt and Alex Highsmith scored touchdowns. That is splash right there.
Splash.
All right. Now that sounds like a TJ Watt who his brothers JJ and Derek are in the pool already, right?
Yeah.
And they're going off the diving board, cannonball, having a good time, but TJ Watt is not a big fan of the water. But his brothers are already in the water. So they went, "Come on, TJ, jump in."
Come on.
He's like, "No, water's cold." "No, you just got to just get in." All right. TJ's going to jump in the pool. He's not happy about it, but his brothers, you know, they're kids and they want him in the pool even though the water's cold. All right. Here's TJ Watt jumping in the water.
Splash.
There it is, right there. He's not excited about swimming with his brothers and cannonball in there. He just, you know, he just ate, and TJ Watt doesn't want to get in the pool after he just ate, but he will because he wants to have fun with his brothers.
Splash.
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 So congratulations to TJ Watt. Just a great dude. He's very Sidney Crosby-like, yeah? Just like you dominate sports.
Yeah.
And you just seem like a great dude, like off the field too. Just great guy, right?
When he talks about it, he doesn't put himself out there like I'm the greatest. It's just like, yeah, it's kind of expected. I'm TJ Watt.
A little hesitant about the pool though.
Splash.
All right, just splash.
Scared of the pool a little bit.
So big win for the Steelers, and now they have another big nationally televised primetime game Sunday night in Vegas against the Raiders. Two just massive Steeler fans. I mean, they got the cast of characters too.
I mean, love is real.
Steelers Pope officiated the wedding, there's all a bunch of Steelers characters around, and this is what some... Who are we talking about here? Who got married at the Steeler tailgate, Bob?
Kevin the Steel Warrior.
Oh, man, Kevin.
And Paula the Steel Princess, Mike.
Oh, man, love was real in the parking lot, and they were married by the Steeler Pope guy, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Paula! Do you promise to take Kevin to as many Steeler games as possible?
Yeah!
To have him obey and to be understanding why Kevin is so upset for days after the Steelers lose?
Oh, man. He customized the vows to make it
real
all Steelers.
Love.
Oh!
She said I do.
Oh, real love!
Kevin!
Oh!
Do you promise to take Paula
for better or bratwurst? Oh, for better or bratwurst, man! Steelers Pope is on fire!
For richer or poorer, you a beer.
Whoa, instead of for richer or poorer, he said, you take Paul for richer or pouring you a beer. Oh my God, Steeler Pope! Somebody put a fire extinguisher on this man! He is on fire!
For as long as she can cook.
For as long as she can cook. All right.
Steelers Pope.
Man, he fumbled at the end there, Steelers Pope.
Right, let's back off the weird whatever we're going.
As long as she can cook.
I don't want to go down this path of what are we doing here with, hey, she's a woman in the kitchen, cook for me. Okay, Steeler Pope. All right.
He said I do.
Okay.
Kevin.
Again, this is what, Paula and Kevin getting married at the Steeler tailgate last night?
Yes.
Getting married by the guy who dresses up as a Steelers Pope.
As a simple of your love for Paula.
Is it going to be rings here? Is it going
to
be rings?
What do you have to give her?
I give her a ring, right?
A terrible time.
Oh,
look
at that. Hell yeah. Hell
Crow
yeah.
Crow goes nuts. All right.
Paula.
It's the wedding at the Steeler tailgate yesterday.
What do you have to give to Kevin to show him your love?
And she's got a towel, too.
Yeah.
All right. Terrible towels are out. They're going to exchange terrible towels instead of rings.
We live in the greatest city in the world.
It really is. You can't beat this.
Steelers Pope is marrying people with terrible towels right now. You kidding me?
For better or...
You kidding me?
For better or bratwurst. Go, if you're married, go home. And ask your significant other.
Steelers Jesus is
there. Do you still love me? Of course I still love you, but for better or bratwurst, I think we all need to ask our significant others that question today.
These towels are a symbol of your eternal love for one another.
Yep.
Okay, if there is anyone here, who sees that this man and woman should not be joined in holy matrimony, then you will be a Pulse fan.
Oh my God!
Steeler Pulse!
Steeler Pulse!
Boom!
Kill him, Steeler Pulse!
Boom!
Kill him! Dude, my man is on fire. He is on fire. If there's anyone here who thinks these people
should not be married,
holy matrimony, as they're exchanging terrible towels, then they must be a bronze fan. Ah!
Here we go.
You wonder how Alex Highsmith picked off that first pass and returned it for a pick six and touchdown?
Mm-hmm.
Was he reading Deshaun Watson's eyes? Did he know the play that was coming? Did he jump the route? No. Love was in the air last night, and that first touchdown, it gets credited to Alex Highsmith, but it was really because love was in the air, true love, last night, as a couple got married outside of the Steeler game.